Welcome to Global Podcast. Global Research recently initiated coverage on the United Arab Emirates real estate sector, covering Amar, Addar, and Suruh, the three largest listed developers in terms of market capitalization. The report discusses the major economic developments and their impact on the UAE real estate sector, as well as the current market situation in terms of demand and supply for new properties and key themes relating to the UAE real estate sector. We welcome Mustafa Al-Maghrabi, a senior financial analyst at Global, to listen to his views on the topic. Mustafa, the real estate sector is usually influenced by the economy. What is your outlook on the UAE's economy and its impact on the real estate sector?
Well, the outlook on the economy is improving year on year. After we saw the economy shrinking by around 1.9% in 2009, we saw it picking up by 2.4% in 2010, and then we're expecting 3.6% in 2011. We think in general that most sectors are gradually picking up, with the exception of perhaps the financial and the real estate sectors. We're still seeing the slowdown. In general, the growth in the economy is driven by the growth in oil prices. The UAE, as an oil exporting country, relies heavily on oil prices and on oil, and it's on the oil revenue of the country in general. Besides that, the one overhang we see in the country is the debt maturity, sovereign debt maturity of both Dubai and Abu Dhabi. We still need to get more confirmation in 2011, 2012. With the upcoming debt maturities of both sovereign debt and government-related entities.
What are the major trends in the real estate sector in the UAE, and what is your outlook on the major markets, especially Dubai and Abu Dhabi?
Well, in general, it's a situation of declining prices on the back of oversupply in both markets, actually, but specifically in Dubai. We've seen this happening for the past 3 years. Since the beginning of the crash, say around 4Q 2008 when the market peaked. And then with some sort of depopulation happening, with people leaving the country and lots of job layoffs happening. Also, this was coupled with the amount of supply that entered the market throughout the last 3 years and that is expected to come in the next 2 years as well. We think that the situation currently is of a vacancy of around 30% of available units in Dubai, and that's a relatively high percentage. Office market is still suffering as well, again, like we said, due to slowing business demand and a continuous supply. In Abu Dhabi, the situation is slightly better, but it's just better because of a lag of the cycle. We're looking at a vacancy of around 5% in most units, in the units available in Abu Dhabi, but this will increase significantly over the next 2 years because of the amount of supply that is entering the market, expected in 2011 through 2013.
Despite the situation in the Dubai market, Global has issued a strong buy recommendation on Amar, which is Dubai-based. Could you please expand on that?
Like we mentioned in the report, in spite of what you mentioned and what we just discussed about Dubai and about Amar being based in Dubai, we don't look at Amar anymore as a Dubai-based developer, specifically in the residential sector. Amar was successful in evolving or in switching itself from a real estate developer sales model to more of a company that relies on recurring income. Basically, when we talk about recurring income, we're talking about the high-class retail portfolio, including Dubai Mall and Marina Mall, and then the retail outlets in the Burj Khalifa development, downtown Dubai. We're also looking at the hospitality sector, which is so far represented by Amar's high-end hotels in Dubai. We think that these sectors are having a stable performance, and we think that this performance is sustainable over the next few years as well. I mean, at least in the outlook, or in our outlook horizon for the next 3 to 4 years. The other positive about Amar that we're looking at is the international operations. We think that Amar is in the verge of delivering most of its international units that are spread over let's say 6-7 countries, mostly in the Middle East, in addition to Pakistan and India as well. It has operations in Canada. It has well diversified its operations, and we think this hedges significantly against the risks that are stemming from being a Dubai-based developer.
And what is the outlook for the Abu Dhabi-based developers, Allar and Suruh?
Well, in Abu Dhabi, the situation is slightly different. Well, to start with, they have a high geographical concentration risk because both developers, Aldar and Suruh, are based in Abu Dhabi. All of their operations is based in Abu Dhabi, unlike Amar that you mentioned, that is diversified outside of the UAE in other markets that has stronger demand prospects. In Abu Dhabi, Aldar and Suruh are both based in geographically confined by the country, and that poses a risk according to what we mentioned a while ago about the position of the situation of the real estate sector in the Emirate. The other thing is that the recurring income portfolio is still not as mature as that of Amar. If we look at Suruh, we think Suruh looks better in terms of liquidity, in terms of project financing over the coming 2 years, where most of the projects will be phasing out. We see visibility in the earnings over the next 2 to 3 years that gives us some sort of confidence in Suruh or in the performance of the stock. Aldar, in spite of the restructuring plan that took place early this year in January 2011, we still think that solvency over the next 3 to 4 years remains an issue. Deliveries are coming up, but we still need to see more improvement on their debt profile.
Thank you for your insights, Mustafa. So Global's initial coverage of the three main players in the UAE real estate sector recommends a strong buy on Amar with a target price of 3.91 dirhams per share, a buy recommendation on Suruh with a target price of 1.52 dirhams per share, and a hold recommendation on Aldar with a target price of 1.51 dirhams per share. To view the full report, please visit our website globalinv.net, where you can find other podcasts on different topics.